Hello, hello. We are live. How's it going? Love to see some chats from you guys. Feel free. I'm just going to pull up a couple little things here. Let's see. Let people get in and... Yeah, come here real quick. You good? No, go ahead. You can go ahead and come here and show me. So here, right? Here, go ahead. Yeah. No, I got the chat pulled up for OBS, yeah. Where? Look. Right there. But there's a chat on YouTube too, right?
You don't need that. It's the same one. But change it so it's not top chat, it's the all.
Okay. You mastered Come Together by the Beatles. Awesome. Love it. And then Ice Cream. Man, that's a good name. How could you break down Black Smoke Rising by Greta Van Fleet? The chorus. Sweet. Hey, BB, what's up? How's it going? I love the wrench, man. So BB is my audio video tech and close friend, and he has been a lifesaver, but he is joining us today. Good to have you, BB. Good to have you guys. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and get started. Ice Cream, your name is so cool. I have to go ahead and do that for you. But first, let me start with one of the requests that we had. What's that? Oh, let me start with one of the requests that we had. Also, please do be sure to like and share the live so other people can check it out as well. I'd really appreciate it. Like and share. Okay, so one of the requests was Slayer, South of Heaven. And so I'm just going to show the beginning part of this. It's pretty cool. Let me show you guys. All right. About 30 seconds here. All right, so that first part, super cool. So you're going to go crash. Right? And let's listen to that again. Okay, they'll do it with me. All right, so the way we're doing that is just single stroke four. It's actually a rudiment. Single stroke four is just right, left, right, left. You're going to hit four single strokes, and that is it. The name of the rudiment tells you what it is. So single stroke four, so crash, two, three, start. Right? Okay, now next part of the fill. Let me listen to it a couple times. So to start with, you're going to come in on four. So one, two, three, four. Same spot you did the other fill. You come in on four. So one, two, three, and then flam on four. Now after that, you're going to go flam left on the snare drum. Flam left, high, high, snare, snare. Just like so. And then... and then two high toms and three snare. So. Right? Flam, snare, high, high, snare, snare. High, high, one, two, three snares here. And then afterwards you do this. Right? One, two, three, tom, tom. Now let's put it together. And there we have it. Awesome. So now both of them. Now that one. Right, so there's several ways you can do that fill. And if you hear there's a thump of a bass at the end. Flat to get the boom, flat to get the boom, flat to get the boom. Listen to that. Okay, so the best way to do that would be right? Or so there's three ways, there's two main ways you can do that. One is you can go flam, mid floor bass, and you're going to start right hand if you do that. Flam, right, left, right, bass, right? The other way is starting left hand and starting on the high tom. You're going to go left, right, left. So you're going to go flam, high mid floor bass, flam, high mid floor bass. Either way is fine. You just want to make sure you have three toms and a bass at the end, because if you listen to it closely, you can definitely hear that thump of the bass drum. All right, cool. Let's check out some comments. Ice Cream is excited. Nice. I'm excited for your name, man. That is awesome. Love it. Why didn't we name one of our kids like Rocky or something for Rocky Road? Jill, hey there, how's it going? All right, so let's see what your request was. Black Smoke Rising by Greta Van Fleet. Let's see, do you know what the timestamp is for the chorus? Let me know when she comments, babe, if you would. Okay, let's see. All right, let me see. Okay, so the first part here is, let me switch cameras for you. Okay, so what we're doing at the beginning, let me listen one more time. I'm at about 37 seconds. So we got crash, bass, bass, snare, right? Crash, bass, bass, snare. Next, crash, bass, bass, snare, and bass, snare, and bass, snare. Now, when you do the and bass snare, the bass is by itself. So you have to do that by itself. Crash, bass, bass, snare, and bass snare, and bass snare, like so. So. Now, let's see what comes after. Okay, so. Right? Let's see what's next. Okay, so largely it's just repeated. Now, I'm hearing hi-hats in there too, or instead of. So you could really safely say, like, you just play it on the hi-hat the whole time, it'll be fine. It's like he starts on the ride and then goes to the hi-hat or mixes it up. So we're just going to say, for ease, it's on the hi-hat instead. Let me play it for you. Yeah! after that, we have a fill. Let's see what that is. Right, so we got snare and hi-hat, and then high floor crash. And let's see. Okay, here it is. All right, so basically you got flam, tom, tom, crash. Right? So you're going to have six total here. One, two, three, four, five, six, and it's going to be a crescendo. Crescendo meaning you go from soft to loud. And then you have two high toms, one mid, one floor, and then crash with the bass. So one, two, three, four, five, six, one, two, one, one, crash. Right? So, right? With music, it sounds like this. And there we go. All right, cool. So that was super fun. Thank you for that request. Let's see. Dark Shadows Reviews. What's up, man? How's it going? And awesome. That was good. Okay, so now let's go ahead and go on to the second request that we had on my post announcing it. If anyone watching live wants to request anything, feel free. Timestamps are helpful. If you can do that, that would be awesome. Okay, so next we're going to do Talking to Myself by, who is it? Let's see. Hang on one sec. Linkin Park. And I believe we're going to start at about 52 seconds. That you keep. Okay, one. All the walls that you keep building. All this time. Okay, so that's the section we're going to cover. Let's listen together. So on this, I want to just point out some of the things that I'm hearing, just a little bit of ear training so that when you listen to songs, you can also tell what the drummer is doing, or at least have kind of a start to start down that road. Sometimes it can be really tough to tell, but we can definitely get there. Oh, Dark Shadows, it's John. What's up, John? How's it going, buddy? Glad you could make it, man. Good to see you. All right, let's see. All the walls that you. So first off, we hear a crash starting it. All the walls. All the walls. And then you hear the thump of a bass with it at the same time. So if you listen for that, you'll hear the crash and the bass. Check it out. All the walls that you keep building. Okay, now the bass and snare are pretty easy to recognize which one's which. If it's the bass, it's a deep thump. If it's snare, it's got that snare sound. So now listening to that, let's just see. I'll kind of air drum it out a little bit. All the walls that you keep building. Okay, so at the end, we have a little change. All the walls that you keep building. Now, so if you were watching what I was doing and listening to that at the same time, you could see how that matched what's going on in the song, right? Bass, snare, bass, snare, snare, right? The harder thing to hear is the hi-hat. He's doing hi-hats consistently there. Right? So let's play it one more time. All the walls that you keep building. All this time that I spent chasing all. And that second time he adds extra bases, which are a double kick and then an extra base at the end. So let's break that down first off. So we got crash 1-2, two hi-hats, crash 1-2, bass snare. Now we could count this 1-E and a 2-E and a 3-E and a 4-E and a 1, right? But I think it helps to just know what you're hitting, right? Especially if you're not familiar with reading and counting music, that can be very helpful. So we got crash 1-2, bass snare. Everything is hit with hi-hat. Crash 1-2, bass snare, 1-2, right? And you're going to do three hi-hats after the snare. So crash 1-2, bass snare, 1-2-3. And then the second half, you're going to do the same, but you're going to add a snare.
All the walls that you keep building.
Okay, so crash 1-2, bass snare, 1-2-3, and then bass 1-2, bass snare, and snare end, right? Snare and snare end with the hi-hat in between each one. Now, let's listen to the second half and see how it differs, right? And feel free to include in the comments if you can hear the difference that's happening or identify even more specifically what do you hear extra in the second half. Same spot, just second half of it. Tell me if you can hear it. Love to see the comment.
All the walls that you keep building, all this time that I spent chasing.
Okay, so at the end, if you guessed it right, we have... let me double check that, actually. Hang on one second.
Time that I spent chasing.
Yeah. Okay, so here is what it is. Bass, 1-2, bass, snare, bass, snare, bass, bass, right? Now, on that double, if that is tough to do that, then not double kicks. Alex, good. Yes, sir. Nice. All right, so if you have trouble doing that double kick, right, feel free to do one. And you could just go bass 1-2, bass, snare, bass, bass instead. That would be totally fine. If not, then you have the double kick there. Bass 1-2, bass, snare, bass, bass, like so. Pretty cool song. I appreciate the request on that.
The ways that I keep losing you. And the truth.
Let me just do the same thing again. So let me play this whole piece real quick with music.
Walls that you, all the walls that you keep building. All the walls that you keep building. All this time that I spent chasing. All the ways that I keep losing you. And the truth.
And then you just stop, and then it goes on. All right, very cool. Awesome. All right, so we have a request. Let me see. American Idiot. Oh, super fun. That's a fun song. 28 seconds to 1 minute. Let's tackle that one real quick. All right. Thanks for the request. I appreciate that. Ah, what's up, Eddie? How you doing, buddy? Good to see you, man. Okay. Let's see. What was the timestamp on that? 28 seconds. Okay. Let's see.
Blood on my America. Welcome to a new car attention. All across the air. On my America. Welcome to a new car attention.
Okay, so this is really, really fast, but basically you're going to be doing really fast eighth notes, and you're going to be matching the guitar. So dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun. So the beat's going to match that. Let me get to where you can see what I'm doing. Okay, so we got... Right? So that matches, totally matches the rhythm of the song, and it helps to remember it because it's like the same.
America.
Okay, so the first part we got. Let me double check. Hang on.
America. America.
That should be it. Let me just double check.
America.
Yeah, so the way to remember is the third snare, right? The third snare is the crash. Okay, so right here, we are going to go bass, bass, snare, bass, end, bass, snare, bass, end, bass, crash. Right? Breaking it down a bit, it's bass, bass, snare, bass. Everything is with hi-hat. There's no independent basses or snares. Bass, bass, snare, bass, and then and, which is hi-hat by itself. Bass, bass, snare, bass, and bass, snare, bass, and bass, crash with the snare drum. Right? Again, it sounds just like the song. Let's see what's after that crash.
America.
Oh, one thing real quick. So after he says America, there's a crash with snare, and then you start it. So if that's kind of been messing you up, just so you know, it's like America. Dun, 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 dun. Right? So that's how you're going to go into it. Usually you would start the crash on the bass where we start here, but you don't do that. So if you were having trouble with this part, it's probably because the crash was a little bit out of place and it threw you off going into the beat. That could be a big reason why. And then, of course, maybe not knowing what the drummer does obviously would be helpful if you knew that too. But now you do. All right, now let's see what's next.
America.
Let me see.
America.
Okay, all right, next. We got bass, bass, snare, and then I believe he crashes. Let me see. He does crash. So we got bass, bass, snare, bass, bass, snare, bass, bass, snare, bass, bass, snare, crash. So bass, bass, snare, and crash is next, right? Right? After the crash with the snare, you're going to have and then you do the bass, bass, snare, and crash. So. And then that is the first section. Let's see what's next. So we got. Let's listen to that really quick. Yeah, that's right. So crash, snare, bass, bass, snare, bass, bass, snare, bass, bass, snare, crash, snare, bass, bass, snare, bass, bass, snare, bass, bass, snare, crash. Right? Totally cool. It matches the song. So breaking that down. Right? And one more piece of it. Let's see. So at the end there, and then let's see what's after that. Okay, so let's see. Right, so we have snare, snare, bass, bass, snare, crash, crash at the end. That's what changes. Snare, snare, bass, bass, snare, crash, crash. Right? Just faster. Let's see. And then, let's see. Very cool, iconic. Okay, I see why you wanted me to go through that part. Let's check out the Tom part. Let's see. Let me listen to it one more time. Let's see. Let me see if it's snare he's hidden. It is the snare, so we got. So yeah. All right, so there's several ways you can do this, Phil, but that's the rhythm that you're going to do. But what you could do is... Right, so you could do a bounce with the right hand. Right, right, left, right. And then one more right. So right, right, left, right, right. Right, or you could go... You could go down, or you could stay on the mid-tom. Either way is fine. All right, very cool. That is super, super fun. Thank you for that request. I appreciate it. All right. Alex always has an awesome song at hand. Let's see. What do we got here? Let me scroll up and see some comments. I dressed up for you guys. I just had my last birthday of my 30s. I had 39 a few days ago. Figure I'd dress up, you know what I mean, in my tux. And let's see. Just so you know, curious what you guys think about this. Okay, so this is a tuxedo shirt, right? I enjoy it. I think it's fun. And my cousin was getting married pretty recently, and I was going to her wedding, and I was like, I'm ready to go, I'm dressed, and I had my tux on, and my wife's like, really? No way. I was like, what? It's a tux. It's a wedding. It fits. Why not? Love to hear your comments. Do you think that this would be appropriate to my beloved cousin's wedding? Love to hear what you think. I say yes. Wife no-no'd me. What do you say? Cousin also, well, no, well, the cousin, you know, she kind of said no because, yeah, you might have led the question when you asked her, but she kind of said no, I guess. She did. She kind of sided. She's like, well, what she said was, if your wife says no, then it's no. So I was like, well, great. That means no. So she kind of sided with her. All right. So what do we have here? Request. Alex, I think you had one. Double kick. Okay. Can you pin that for me? Okay. Question. When you're doing, oh, there we go. Thank you. When you're doing double kick to a faster paced song, like Smells Like Teen Spirit, are you lifting your leg? Hang on. Are you lifting your leg to do the double, or is that just ankle movement? Great question. Thank you. I find that I can do 110 beats per minute using my leg to move the foot. When you get up to 120, you lose all the power in your second kick. Oh yeah, super common. Okay, so if you're losing power in your second kick, there is definitely a reason why. Now, the whole purpose of this live that I do, first of all, is because I you know, there's thousands of song requests that I've had, so I want to do this for you guys to whatever request you have. And not just songs, but as Alex asked, you know, technique and music theory and sticking and rudimentary applications, you know, like, hey, how do you do some cool rudiments on the drum set? You know, I could show that kind of stuff too. So I appreciate the question. So in answer to that, let me switch to my foot view and I will explain. Okay, so first question, Alex, is are you doing heel up or are you doing heel down? That is a very important question. Babe, just let me know when he answers that if you don't mind. Okay, so if you're doing heel down, you're using your tiny little shin muscle right here, right? So think about how big that muscle is versus if you're doing heel up, which I'll explain the technique of that here in a minute, you're now using that tiny shin muscle and your calf and part of your quad muscle and maybe even a little bit of your hamstring in addition. Heel up? He's doing heel up. Okay, cool. So since you're doing heel up, that's great. But you know, what I was saying is if you are doing heel down, you're using a tiny little piece of muscle. If you're doing heel up, you got that, your calf, your quad, way more muscles. So it's no different than working out, right? If you work out with, you know, going up all the way and using all of your biceps, then, you know, you can have a lot more muscle mass and you can have guns like this, right? Are you laughing? My wife just laughed. I don't know what to think about that. Crushed. Anyway, so, but, you know, if you're using more muscle, then you can get stronger much, much faster. It's like using more of your brain, you'll be smarter, in theory. Using more of your muscles, you'll be able to get more. So since you are doing heel up, let me explain. So heel up. If you have a weak second foot, it could be your second kick. It could be because you're let's back up for a second. So let me just explain the theory behind this. Okay. So relax your foot totally. Your beater, which is what actually hits the bass drum, should be up. Now what you do is you want to be 3/4 of the way up on the pedal, not all the way, not halfway, 3/4 of the way. And you're going to raise your heel, and you notice that when I do this, the beater buries, and I continue to raise my heel. So doing it again, it buries, I continue to raise my heel. Now, the most important part of this is that you're prepared correctly, right? So when I do this, I don't have any tension in my quad. My quad is not tight. It's very loose. So it's 90% of the weight of my leg on the ball of my foot, which is holding that beater down, right? So you shouldn't be like pushing or straining or tightening up your calf or your quad muscle. It should just be relaxed and your heel is up, and you are going to have some tension in your calf, but you're just resting the weight of your leg on the ball of your foot. So that's a critical first step. If you're holding your leg up, then you're not going to get the power out of your ankle stroke, and that might be what's happening with you, Alex, possibly. So now from here, you raise up higher, and you kick with the ball of your foot, right? And you can push down with your big toe. That's really helpful, too. Now, in doing double kicks, think of it like skipping rocks on a lake, right? If you skip rocks on a lake, and, for example, you have too much of an angle, well, you're going to go way up and then toe and then way down and ball. Well, you're not going to be able to have a really powerful second kick, and you're going to go really slowly. But if you angle it just right and you skip that rock like this, it'll go several times on the water before it finally goes under. So it's the same thing. Now, we only want two hits, but you get the idea. You want to have the right angle of force coming into the pedal. So now you raise your heel and you suck in your toes. Now what this does is it gets you in a position where you're hitting with the toe and then sliding forward for the ball. And what I do when I do that, you see my heel go up and then I slide forward. So I'm actually getting two hits out of one motion, right? So I'm going toe, ball. I prepare it and then I toe, ball, and it slides into it. So if you're having a weak second, it could be because you're holding your leg up and you're just sliding your foot forward. And if you notice, that's not a very powerful stroke. But when I use my heel and my ankle and I go toe and it kind of sucks my foot back, toe ball, I have a much, much more powerful stroke. Now, doing Smells Like Teen Spirit, for example, watch my foot. Right? And I'm doing that toe ball really fast. So in the meantime, to help with that, you can push down harder on your foot, and that will help you get that second stroke much, much more powerful in there. Great question, Alex. I'd love to hear your feedback on that. I hope that helped you, buddy. What is next? What do we got now? Is your foot kind of coming off, though, when I hit? So your foot should never leave the pedal. I'm going to call you Rocky. Rocky Road Ice Cream. Your name's Rocky now. So your foot should never leave the pedal. Your heel's never going to touch the pedal, but your foot as a whole is never going to leave it, because if it does, it's a waste of motion. Here to here does nothing, right? So it's a total waste of motion. So if you're doing something really fast, you don't have time to take your foot off the pedal. So answer to that is definitely never. You're never going to take your foot off the pedal. The heel is never on it, but the ball or toe area is never off it. It's just going to slide back and forth. All right, next question. How do you say that? Miglito? Is that it? You're welcome, Alex. Go your play the song. What's that? Can you? Okay. Can you play the song Beautiful Day? Let me check it out. Oh, BB said something. What did BB say? Jill, mama, Dinga, lots of Jeremy's favorite exercise. What is that? With your left hand, I have the same problem. No, no, I know. Oh, that's her whole name. Okay. I was like, what is BB doing right now? Jeremy's favorite exercise, crazy eights. What was her question? Can you show me that real quick? Oh, here it is. How do I not drop the drumstick out of my left hand? It's slippery and maybe a stupid question. Absolutely not a stupid question. BB, thank you for bringing that to my attention. That is an awesome question. So BB is correct. So lots of crazy eights. And crazy eights is basically, let me switch to my side view here. Okay, so Crazy Eights is basically the Mortal Kombat theme, right? So you're going to double four times and then go 1-2. So just to show you the rhythm, and then I'll explain how you hold the sticks, the rhythm is going to be this. Now, more importantly than just doing that rhythm is how you do it, or any other rhythm. That's just a really good exercise that I really like to use. So, in short, one of the main reasons why you may drop your stick is because of your fulcrum. So, the fulcrum is your thumb and index finger of your grip. It is the most important part. It's so important it has its own name. Now, when you do that, when you have the fulcrum, you want your thumb to face down the shaft of the stick like that. So, you don't want it to be like pointing to the side. Because when it points off to, let me do this hand. So when it points to the side like that, what happens? It creates a big gap here. And if you have a gap and you're playing, you can imagine what's happening. Oh, shoot, I dropped the stick. Because it gives it too much wiggle room in there. And when you're playing, you could throw it backwards. You could throw it down. It could just fall between your fingertips. So you want, what's going to help you is if you have the thumb straight, it's not going to allow a gap. And then you can squeeze that to where you could put a quarter in between and it would stay, or you know, or even a drumstick and it would stay in between there. So now it doesn't have that big hole to flop around in and drop your stick anymore. So that's the main way to not drop your sticks there. The second way, kind of as a safeguard, is to have your middle ring and pinky finger on the bottom side of the stick. You don't have to have a death grip tight or anything, but to have it on the bottom, and you can even do a fingering technique, right, where you're squeezing with your fingers, but mainly it's there to kind of act as a safeguard in case for whatever reason it slips out of your fulcrum, that these are preventing it from falling from your stick falling out of your hand, right? So that's just an extra safeguard. And there's a lot of depth. If anybody has any questions about how to build up speed in your arms, then we're going to go back to Crazy Eights and I'll tell you specifics of how to do it. You don't just do it. There's a very, very specific way. But whatever you're doing, just practice always keeping that gap closed and the thumb straight and those fingers on. I see a lot of drummers doing the Englishman thing, drinking a cup of tea or something, or curving that pinky out. It's one of the worst habits there is in all of drumming, and it eliminates a whole muscle structure in your muscle group in your arm, and it eliminates a finger to help keep the stick in your hand. So awesome question. I hope that was helpful. Thank you again, BB. Appreciate that. All right, and that was from Jill Mama Dinga. Love the name. All right, let's see. Beautiful. Was I going to do beautiful? No, I already did. Yeah, beautiful day, right? Okay. All right, beautiful day. Here we go. Let me get it pulled up. And if you're just joining, please be sure to like and share. I really appreciate it, guys. Feel free to ask anything you want me to go over. Okay, YouTube, beautiful.
The heart is a blue, shoots up through the stony ground. There's no.
Okay, all right, so there's several ways you can do this, actually. I'm going to give you one option that's probably the best and most consistent way to do it. So first, you notice that he was doing three basses, right, the whole time. And then it starts. The music starts, and the basses don't change. That's important. The basses did not change at all. He just added everything else in around it.
Shoots up. Hot as a balloon. Hot as a balloon.
Let's see.
The hot as a balloon.
Okay, so how he starts is on the second bass drum. So we got 1-2-3, 1-2-3, 1-2-3. Okay, so what he's doing there is really, I feel like it would be a lot easier and better and more accurate to the song if you did eighth notes. So you're just going to hit everything with the hi-hat, right? And that's a really good way to start that. There's a couple of different variances you can do that definitely add the difficulty, one of them being quarter notes instead of eighth. And the other one is like, you know, something like that where you can add some extra hi-hats. But in short, just go, whenever you're doing the three basses and the song starts, it's going to be on the second bass drum that you start. 1-2-3, 1-2-3, right? And then there you go. So let's see what's next.
Shoots up.
Okay, so that fill is, you have the three basses, right? So bass, 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 snare, bass, 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 snare. So the simplest way to explain this fill is instead of doing three basses, you're going to do one bass and substitute the second and third bass for a tom. So instead of going bass, 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 you're going to go bass, high, floor. So bass, 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 snare, bass, 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 snare, bass, 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 snare, bass, high, floor, crash, right? Right? Bass, 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 snare, bass, high, floor, crash, and that is your fill. Watch, check it out.
Bass, it's a beautiful day. I had in return for grace. It's a beautiful day.
Now, after that, so bass, high, floor, flam, bass, crash is the whole fill. So we got bass, 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 snare, bass, high, four, flam, bass, crash. Okay, awesome. And then we get into the chorus.
It's a beautiful day. Sky falls, you feel that. It's a beautiful day.
Awesome. And you know what I think I'm going to do, because I want to get to some other requests really quick here. What I'm going to do is start with that, and then if you can join us on the next live, then give me the timestamp for that next section, and I will show you the next section next time. But that's a good start for you to get that those transitions down. The transitions are always the trickiest part. All right, what do we got? BB, you still here, buddy? Let's see. Dennis Dean, request, broke. What's that? Oh, sorry, Denise Dean. Okay, I need glasses, I think. Yeah, Denise, there we go. Sorry, Denise. Why is it not zooming out? So babe, it's huh? Yeah, I know, but it let me, there we go. It just didn't let me zoom out. I couldn't read anything. Bro Code by Brantley Gilbert. Let's check out Bro Code. And there's no specific timestamp, no? The beginning. Okay. All right, let's check it out.
Look at you, girl.
Okay, so basically, here's what you're going to do. Let me get to where you can see me, sorry. Let's see. Okay, here we go. Let me listen to one thing. All All right, so something a little bit harder to hear is he's flamming and he doesn't hit the hi-hat there. So it's... Now, you don't have to flam. You can just do this. Bass and snare and bass and bass snare E and a bass and snare and bass snare E and a... But it is a flam. So breaking that beat down, it's bass and snare, right? Bass and snare and bass and. So right there, that bass is independent, meaning it's just the bass by itself and bass by itself and. Now, talking a little bit of technique and music theory, when you do, anytime you have that and bass and, then you have a bass independent while the right hand is playing a hi-hat or a ride cymbal. It's a really good idea just to try to keep it really smooth with your up and down stroke. But also, if you think about it, and bass, and if you're going away from the hi-hat when it's bass by itself, you're going to be less tempted to hit the hi-hat. So you're going to be tempted to go and bass, and, but that's wrong. You got to go and go away from it on the bass, and. Because if you're actively moving away, it's much less tempting. Rather than if you were going like your stick's just here kind of hovering, you're probably gonna hit it, right? So and bass and down up down with your hand. Down up down like so. Now after that, bass and snare and bass and bass snare and, right? And you're going to add extra hi-hat. So bass and snare and, bass, snare, E, and a bass. Snare, E, and a bass. So you're going to go fast there, 16th notes. Or with flams. Or all of it flammed. You just got to get there really quick, especially if you do the flammy end of, right? Flammy end of bass. So if you were going to do the flam, I would recommend what you do is do a flam on the first snare and not the second. Bass and flam and bass snare E and a bass like that. All right. Great request, man. Love it. Love it. Love it. All right. What do we have next? BB is here. Nice. What up? Oh, Cody's here. Uh-oh. So... I gotta say this. Cody knows what I'm about to say. if you were with us on our last live, or you watched the last live, you would have seen me do Moby Dick and the crazy solo in the middle of it. So Cody is not a drummer, and he just Googled what's a crazy hard drum part and looked it up, and it said Moby Dick, and he picked it and threw it on there. So what's up, man? How's it going? All right. Do we have any other requests? Let me see. You're welcome, Denise. You are welcome. What's that? By the way, you guys, if you haven't seen, I haven't publicly announced it yet, but I am going to be announcing it. But if you go to the website, e7musicschool.com, I have a membership available that breaks down full song. It's videos of full song breakdown. So if you want to check that out, I have it at a really super cheap price right now, $14.99 a month. Ultra cheap. It will be going up from that, but right now you'd be grandfathered in. Again, it's e7musicschool.com, and just go to the membership, video course membership tab, and you can check it out, and you can see the videos, and really cool. There's going to be more added every month. Largely every week or two is going to be more and more songs added on there. Okay, so what's the request here, babe? Oh, from, what's that?
There's another one too, but I don't think there's time.
Okay. Yellow Ledbetter. Oh, that's a fun one. Okay. And then Ice Cream had, what was Ice Cream's? I'm having trouble with speeding up single strokes in general. Tell you what. Excuse me, Alex, let's save that one for next time. When you join me in the next live, just ask me that one, okay? So Ice Cream, having trouble with speeding up single strokes in general. Yes, that is a touchy, touchy skill to develop. All right, so let me show you. So in single strokes, if you're having trouble doing it, like if I saw you do it, it would be very, very helpful because I could see what you're doing wrong and direct you, hey, so that's the problem, let's do it. But in general, most common problems I have that I see in students is, one, you may be using your arm. So let's just establish that this is not the case, right? So if you use your arm versus your wrist versus your fingers also you can go much faster using your fingers and wrist than you can with just your wrist, and you can do faster either one of those two than you can moving your whole arm, right? So first off, you want to make sure that you're using the right parts of your limb and not finding yourself, you know, animal on the Muppets kind of thing, which I see all the time. I see that all the time. So that's step number one. Number two, a great exercise, as BB said, is Crazy Eights, which I tell you what, if you can join the next live, I will go over in detail that. That would take a bit to go over, but I totally will next time. But in short, on this one, the best thing you can do for right now is just grab your arm, and what you're going to do is to practice fingering technique. The best way to do is hold your stick like this, and then you're going to just practice. You're going to move your wrist back and forth. If you notice that my wrist is moving, but my fingers are also kind of guiding the stick back. So I don't like full on squeeze my palm or anything, but it's guiding the stick back as well. And you're just going to let that stick hit the center of your palm right here. And this is going to keep banging against the center of your palm. So you get that motion with your fingers also. It's not going to feel natural at all, and you're probably going to be like this at first maybe, or, you know, your fingers are never going to leave the stick. Just kind of a guide, right? So just relax. You don't want to be super tense. Just relax and let your wrist move and your fingers guide it. And then what you do is you come down to the snare. And when you start hitting the snare, the rebound of the stick is no longer going to hit the palm of your hand, because you have your hand's on top of it and it's stopping it from coming the rest of the way. So you get the feel of that bouncing off your palm, and then when you go to the snare drum, it's not bouncing on your palm anymore, and now you can have a nice single stroke. So now let's just apply that to see what it sounds like. And then you have a really nice, fast single stroke roll. You're going to be wrecked right here. It's just going to really hurt. I mean, well, it's really sore. It's not, you're not going to be like physically, oh my gosh, I'm in pain, you know, but you're going to be really, really sore very, very quickly. So you want to try to get that down. I would recommend you start, assuming you're right-handed, I would recommend you start left hand first and build it up. And just go until your arm like dies, and then do the right hand, and then do the left hand again, right? And then once you've done that, stretch them out, do like the helicopter, you know what I mean, side to side. And then once you've done that, then do it again and try both of them together. And just start slow and then gradually speed up like that. That'll really help develop a lot of speed in there. Also, one last thing, I highly recommend you do German grip. German grip is where your hands are flat. So if you had a quarter, you could put it on top of your hand and it would stay. This is French grip. You see a lot of drummers play French grip. I have several reasons why I'm personally not a fan at all of French grip, but it is an acceptable grip. And then there's German. I definitely prefer German for many, many reasons, but I would recommend that you have that hand flat to where if you had a quarter and you stopped playing, it would be flat and the quarter would be there, right? All right, very good. Awesome. Okay, that's a beautiful kit. Also playing Pearl. That is correct. Thank you, Felix. I appreciate it. Alex, I appreciate you. Denise, thanks so much. Cody, thanks for not wearing me out with a crazy song. BB, I appreciate you. Ice Cream, you're awesome. Let's see, what'd you say? I haven't seen an exercise like that. Thanks so much. You are very welcome. Yeah, my pleasure, man. All right, so guys, thank you so much for joining the live today. I really appreciate it. I would love to hear your feedback in the comments as well. It'll be posted. I'm going to do a little bit of edits to it, and then I'll post it So I'd love to hear some comments from you guys afterwards as well. Things you like, if you have any suggestions for me, not just songs, but if you have suggestions like, hey, maybe if you did this differently or this, then, you know, it'd go faster, whatever. You know, any kind of thoughts or feedback are always appreciated. I really appreciate you guys watching. Thank you so much for all the awesome questions. And I will see y'all next time, next month in February.